largest royal flotilla in centuries. The Diamond Jubilee Thames Pageant, today at 1:30, BBC One and BBC One HD. A party 60 years in the making.
Well, that is the London Philharmonic Orchestra. They've been playing non-stop since Cadogan Pier. They've covered UK themes, they've covered a famous tune, of course, Nimrod, which is associated with the military, as well as Fantasia on Sea Songs, Pomp and Circumstance, Henry V, overtures, and a little ditty called the Padstow Lifeboat, which seems to be appropriate for today. And the James Bond theme was one of the small pleasure boats which was in the one of the James Bond films, Let Die, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah, she rejoiced in the name of Shaken Not Stirred.
Glass Fronted Vessel Symphony, hosting the musicians from one of the country's most respected orchestras, directed by David Parry. There of the orchestra, which was accompanied by the Royal College of Music Chamber Choir, conducted by Thomas Blunt. So please don't think that we switched them off deliberately, but you can imagine with the rain the way it is, there are a few technical problems, but we've got a wonderful crew here looking after us. And there's some very brave people on top of that craft. Exposed to the elements, but it didn't dim their enthusiasm to sing Land of Hope and Glory.
Very seaman-like effort by the singers, I'd say.
A thunderous round of applause, because they really do deserve it. Thank you.
the gentleman on the spirit of Chartwell. Slinking into the background, really, Lord Salisbury, the chairman of Thames Diamond Jubilee Foundation, and a huge amount of work on behalf of everybody to get this pageant up and running and then to completion. Nice little side comment was that he was the great-great-grandson of the current Lord Salisbury, who was Prime Minister at the time of Queen Victoria's Diamond Jubilee. But certainly that moment from the orchestra and the singers, sort of mildly eccentric moment in some ways, but one that the British do so well. Thank you.
come to an end, but the salute to Queen Elizabeth continues. It's hard to say, hard to imagine that things can go back to normal after this. It has been such an extraordinary day. HMS Belfast paying their tribute. This certainly has been a day that will live long in my memory, just in terms of the preparation to get this pageant right has been going on for years. But I think, despite the weather, they got it right, and it will be something that the population of this great city and the rest of the country and worldwide will remember for many years to come.
To the most memorable of days. We're just opposite Belfast, and the studio lifted, didn't it? Absolutely.
Well, very quickly, Anna Whitelock, our historian, has been with us all afternoon. We've just seen a bit of history we made there, haven't we? Absolutely, and I think 60 years on, I mean, the Queen's pledged herself again to her people. I mean, she stood up the whole way through, which I think says everything. And in this long conversation that's been going on for centuries between royalty and the people, I think this moves into a whole new phase. I think it's been a kind of cathartic conversation that's been played out between the people and the monarchy today over the river. And I think that it's been affirming. I mean, I think the Queen could step down from the barge feeling like another day, you know, job well done. And she's been on her feet the whole way through. Well, thank you for joining us all the way through as well.
Pleasure. And who cares what happened with the weather, eh? That's what I say. Anyway, thanks to you, Anna, and thanks so much to our team of reporters and the many guests who have joined us this afternoon, as well as part of our coverage on the BBC on this historic day.
We will hand you right now back to Hugh Edwards, who is getting ready for the next instalment, because there is another one in the Queen's Diamond Jubilee Diary.
Yes, the concert that will happen tomorrow evening will take place right outside Her Majesty's front door in Buckingham Palace. It's set to be a start to the chill.
So thank you to everyone who joined us today for this spectacular, if a little bit soggy event on the River Thames, but do enjoy the rest of your extended bank holiday. Bye-bye.
Matt and Sophie and Paul as well, with all that commentary to do, thank you very much. I'm going to let you into a secret, okay? As someone who was brought up in South Wales...
The events that I have attended to mark my Diamond Jubilee have been a humbling experience. It has touched me deeply to see so many thousands of families, neighbours and friends celebrating together in such a happy atmosphere. But Prince Philip and I want to take this opportunity to offer our special thanks and appreciation to all those who have had a hand in organising these Jubilee celebrations. It has been a massive challenge, and I'm sure that everyone who has enjoyed these festive occasions realises how much work has been involved. I hope that memories of all this year's happy events will brighten our lives for many years to come. I will continue to treasure and draw inspiration from the countless kindnesses shown to me in this country and throughout the Commonwealth. Thank you all.
Next I'll be teenage boys.